Hi, Joltter from Unisport Web TV. This time in St. George's Park, where Nike invited us to experience what it's like to be a professional footballer for 48 hours. It's gonna be 2 days full of action while trying on the latest Nike gear, so let's kick it off right away.
First of all, welcome to St. George's Park. It's always nice to have Unisport here. First part of your experience is really a training experience.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we are here at the St. George's Park living the dream of being professional footballers. And step one is, of course, to maintain your physique. We are going to the gym. I'm not 100% sure what we're going to do, but I'm pretty sure we're going to get tested, you know, put our physics through a serious test. Your boy's ready. Let's go.
So this is what we call our human performance lab. So this is where we can get all the facts and figures and numbers on the athletes and football players that come to St. George's Park. So you can assess their fitness and strength, mobility, flexibility in various ways to see have they got any causes of injury or potential causes of injury that we can pick up on our pieces of equipment.
All right. Well, summing up the jumping, I'm not quite the Cristiano Ronaldo level of hitting the ball, but it wasn't too bad. 41 centimeters, last jump, third take, vamos. In that test, we basically tested out the balance and flexibility and if there are any differences, you know, between my left and my right leg. And there were none.
Brilliant screen. So not only have you got really far, you're completely equal on both sides as well. So spot on. Brilliant screen.
Nailed it.
Very flexible and very controlled under the movement.
Perfect. I'm going to try my best to hit the spots. Let's see how I'm going to do. Stephanie, just film it, we have to get it on tape.
Yeah, effectively what we tried to do was replicate some of the exercises that we would typically do with soccer players. So initially there was a circuit, a core-based circuit. We then went into more of a multi-movement, multi-loaded circuit, 30 seconds on, 30 seconds off. My philosophy on conditioning soccer players is about multi-movement intensity, and of course doing things at a high speed, so which is replicating the demands of soccer.
Two, one, game!
This is the killer one. I have to pull ups, all these things.
Ready, go. Two,
this is the one that's killing
one,
me.
Change.
So, ladies and gentlemen, yesterday's gym session, I can still feel it in my muscles. Today, all geared up with the Revolution jackets. This is what I've been looking forward to, getting the professional experience with, of course, the brand new Nike Highlight Pack colourways. All eyes on your boy, number 10. Let's go, Unisport Life. Done with the playmaking ball position with the Tiempo. Next up we have a scoring exercise with the Hypervenom. Hypervenom is still my favorite Nike boot, so I have high expectations. So, we are done with the Hypervenom drill. Scoring wise, I did score one goal, end of story. Now we're moving on to Magista in the pretty popping bright new colorway. I'm pretty confident that the next drill it's gonna be about playmaking. Let's rock and roll.
Today's sessions was really to give you a taste of how the academy trains and the different styles of play within the academy. So we've had attacking play, defensive play, clever play as well, 1v1 battles. All them ingredients to make up a good academy player.
Honest opinion and all, how do you think the players did here?
I think the players did incredibly well, to be honest with you, because it looked like football. There was some good play at various moments, and we're pleasantly surprised with what we've seen.
So, we're done with our first football session. Now, we're getting ready for more action. We're going to go through some tactics with our teams, and later on in the afternoon, we're going to play a big 11-a-side tournament. So, the experience is not over.
We know what we're doing, we play out from the back, and also though, pass it, pass it and move it. Don't worry about, like, you know, too many touches. Just keep the ball moving with good ball speed. Let's go and win the 20 minutes first. Go and give everything. Enjoy it. Encourage each other and you will have good fun.
Mario Götze, what would you say has been, you know, the number one lesson or piece of advice you've got that, you know, took your career to where it is now?
Ich glaube, das Wichtigste ist wirklich, dass man nie von seinem Weg abkommt, dass man immer sagt, ich habe ein Ziel vor Augen, das verfolge ich und egal was passiert, ob es mal eine Niederlage ist, ein Rückschlag, egal ob es eine Verletzung ist, ob man lange nicht spielen kann, dass man immer sagt, ich bin fokussiert, ich weiß, was ich möchte, ich weiß, wie ich fit bin, wie ich spielen kann und dass man eigentlich immer an sich glaubt. Das ist das Wichtigste.
So, everything we've done here at the St. George's Park was leading up to these points. Playing 11-a-side here, floodlit pitch, everything is beautiful. And yeah, we were visited by Mario Götze, Jerome Boateng and James Milner, and referee on the pitch was none other than Howard Webb. Howard Webb, I'm just saying. Anyways, now everyone is very tired, you know, it's been a long couple of days going to the gym, playing football, playing 11-a-side, and what we have left right now is, of course, recovery session. So let's get inside. I'm getting cold. Let's get this over with it.
So, after cooling down at the spa with some well-deserved and much-needed recovery treatment, our journey here at St. George's Park is more or less over. And boy, have we done it all. We saw the new Nike highlights pack, tried all the four boots on at the training ground, along with the new Revolution jacket, and most important of all, got a glimpse into the everyday life of being a professional footballer. Obviously, it's been a very tough couple of days, as you can probably see, but I guess this just goes to show you how much it actually takes to take your game to the very top. But what do you guys actually think about everything? All this madness we've experienced here at St. George's Park. You should let me know in the comment section below, because this was all we had for you for today, but we're back again later, as always, right here on Unisport Web TV. I'm out. So, Salah, do you think we have a good one already?
No.
No? For real? We have it, right? I can't do this anymore. But what do you guys actually think? My voice. Okay, let's cut one more time.